So we're going to have a little overview of different plots we can make for describing the relationship between two variables. One categorical and one numeric variable, two categorical variables, and then two numeric variables. A quick reminder to subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications when we upload new videos. Plots are a great way that we can visualize and explore whether or not two variables are associated and the nature of that association if they are. Later on, we're going to talk about analytic techniques we can do to analyze the relationship between two variables. If you recall, variables are either categorical or numeric, and the plots we can make, as well as the methods of analysis, depend largely on the type of variables that we're looking at. So let's start off with one categoric, one numeric. The plot we can make here is side-by-side box plots. So one example we can think of, let's draw this here, is if, say, we were looking at, does someone have skin cancer? Yes and no. And the other variable, how many hours per day in the sun? And what we'd likely see is for those with skin cancer, here's the distribution of the number of hours in the sun. And for those without, we'd likely see that distribution a little bit lower. Okay, so here we can see through this plot, there is an association. Those who have skin cancer tend to, on average, be spending more hours in the sun than those that don't. And just for the sake of talking about what no association would look like, let's think of looking at biological sex, male or female. So that's our categorical variable. And our numeric variable, body temperatures. And if we make a plot of the body temperature distribution for males, and for females, it'd probably end up looking pretty similar. Okay, so this is a visual of there being no association. So these are very commonly seen plots in a lot of papers or discussions. They really help us describe relationship between one categorical and one numeric variable. So now let's think about plots that we can make for two categorical variables. Here, there's a number of different plots that exist, each with good and bad qualities to them. So the first one we'll talk about is side-by-side bar charts. Okay, and so the example I'm going to use for our two categorical variables, the first one will think, does someone smoke or do they not smoke? Okay, and the other variable we'll look at, do they have lung cancer, yes or no? So on this axis, we'll put the percentage. And what we'd likely see is something like this, going from 0 up to 100%. And here I'm drawing it, so well, let me label these. We'll do this dash here as those who have lung cancer, and we'll do it with no dashes for the group with no lung cancer. Okay, so here, for those who smoke, roughly 1/3 are getting lung cancer, 2/3 are not. For those who don't smoke, roughly about 10% getting lung cancer, 90% not getting lung cancer. Okay, so again, here we can see there's an association. Another version, similar, is a stacked bar chart. And it's pretty similar to the side-by-side bar chart, except we take these and we stack them on top of each other. Okay, so taking the exact same set of data, but looking at it as a stacked bar chart, here's the smoking group, here's the non-smoking, I'll just abbreviate that NS. Again, here's the percentage going from 0 up to 100, and we'd have roughly 1/3 getting lung cancer, 2/3 not. Okay, so again, the dashed lines for those with lung cancer, the no dashed line for those with no lung cancer. And for the non-smoking group, we had roughly 10% with lung cancer and about 90% without. Okay, so pretty similar plot to the side-by-side, except we stack them vertically. So again, here we can see there appears to be an association. Now, another plot, and this is one that I like a little bit more, is a mosaic plot. And that's because it conveys a little bit of extra information. So let me draw that in here and then label what some of the parts are and what's being shown in that. So for the most part, it's pretty similar to this stacked bar chart, except if we pushed these two stacks together. Here is the smoking, and here is the non-smoking. And remember in our example, we said there's roughly, for the smokers, 1/3 getting lung cancer, 2/3 not. So let me label that again over here. These are the group with lung cancer, and the unshaded is the group without lung cancer. And for the non-smokers, we saw about 10% getting lung cancer, 90% not. So let's talk about this plot for a moment. Okay, so this plot shows pretty much what we saw in that stacked bar chart. So let me go and label those. We can see for the group that smokes, we can see roughly 1/3 are getting lung cancer. In other words, for those who smoke, roughly 1/3 get lung cancer. And here we can see for those who do not smoke, right, so this total stack is 100%, roughly 10% are getting lung cancer, right? So again, for those who do not smoke, roughly 10% get lung cancer. Okay, so it's showing pretty much what we could see in that stacked bar chart, except it conveys this extra info as well. The width of the smoking and non-smoking stack tells us the proportion of smokers and non-smokers. So this goes from 0 up to 100 as well. And this distance here gives us the percentage who smoke. And this distance here gives us the percentage who do not smoke. Okay, so again, pretty similar to the stacked bar chart, except it gives us one extra additional piece of info. The width of the bars for the smokers and non-smokers tells us the proportion of our sample that smokes or does not smoke. Now I'm just going to draw one more mosaic plot. I won't label as much, but I'm going to draw the same plot, but if there was no association between smoking and lung cancer. The way that plot would end up looking, okay, and again, all the same x and y axes, it would end up forming roughly a cross pattern. Okay, and what that's telling us here is the proportion getting lung cancer for those who smoke and those who do not smoke are roughly the same. Okay, there is no association between the two. Okay, so like I said, the mosaic plot, that's my favorite out of these because it conveys the most info in one picture. The final set is talking about describing the relationship between two numeric variables. And to do this, we can use a scatter plot, okay, which sometimes gets called an XY plot. I've run out of space, so I'm just going to draw those in over here. So again, I'll do two examples, one with an association, one without. So we might say, look at age going from 0 up to 20. Okay, so these are looking for a group of children, okay, kids. And here's height. And what we'd likely see is something like this. As age increases, height is increasing, right? There's an association between the two. What would this plot look like if there was no association? Here's age, and now let's do it for a group of adults. So let's say going from age 20 up to age 65. And again, on this axis, we're looking at height. We would just see a cloud of points, right? No real association. Okay, and that's for a group of adults. There's not really an association between your age and height, right? Between the ages of 20 and 65, we're done growing, and we're not quite shrinking yet. So later on, we're going to start to learn different methods of analyses that we can do depending on the type of data we have. Just to mention the quick keywords now, one categorical, one numeric, we can look at things like two sample t-test, analysis of variance, and other methods. Two categorical variables, we might look at chi-squared test, Fisher's test, odds ratios, rate ratios, these sorts of things. And two numeric variables, Pearson's correlation or Spearman's correlation, simple linear regression, and those.
Thanks for watching our video. Subscribe to our channel. Share our videos. Statistics is almost as yummy as chocolate. Stick around, guys, because we got lots more.